StarCraft fans all around the world, hello. My name is William Cho, and I will be your host for the Legacy of the Void cinematic and street date reveal. We've been here in beautiful Kraków, Poland for a day and a half already for the World Championship Series Season 3 Finals. And, of course, with a beautiful city comes amazing people. So, yes, Kraków! You guys have been awesome all weekend. If you've been watching the World Championship Series at all, you know it's been an absolute insane weekend, and it's about to get better because we're all here gathered together for a momentous occasion to watch the Legacy of the Void cinematic together and find out when we're going to get our hands on such an amazing game. But before we jump into it, StarCraft means something to all of us, something different. We all have our history and story with StarCraft, but if anyone has something more to share about the StarCraft universe, of course, it's going to be the creators themselves. So as we get started, let's check out StarCraft through the eyes of Blizzard.
When I joined the team, StarCraft 2 was going to be a single game, and it was so important for us to get it right.
For the development of StarCraft 2, there were certain expectations, and those were huge expectations to meet, but there was also, how are we going to make it different and better?
We knew that the multiplayer was going to be very conservative in its approach. There was going to be a siege tank, right? There was going to be a Marine, there was going to be a Zealot. This was going to be this game, and that a lot of players were looking for something more from us as well. And so we felt like the campaign would be an area where we could do more.
We knew that we wanted to keep Jim Raynor, Sarah Kerrigan, a lot of the classic characters from the first game, because people who weren't necessarily the super multiplayer esports fans, the single-player campaign fans, they're just as ravenous on this game as the multiplayer fans. You know, they want to know what's happening next, so we continue the storyline.
Chris Metzen in particular, he wanted to push the storytelling to a new level, something that no other game has done. It was a big undertaking.
Next thing I know, I'm sitting in script meetings where we're looking at big old thick scripts, and you know, we're like, wow, we have completely, you know, jumped into the deep end of the pool. But we were super excited, and now we had two weapons to tell stories, you know, the pre-render and then the real time, and this really cool interweaving of big story moments and the smaller moments that were just as critical.
All in a day's work, General.
We were looking at a game that was probably 70 to 80 missions, and we didn't want to cut it for the story, because we liked the story that we were telling, and we didn't want to cut it for the choices you get in the campaign. And so we're looking at this and going, well, what are we going to do? We can't do 80 missions and not be done before probably 2015.
So we made the decision to cut it into three. And, you know, it was kind of this, oh God, what have we done, right? Like, now we really can do this, but we gotta deliver on it.
Are you ready for StarCraft 2?
StarCraft 2 is one of the best things we've ever done. And I think from a sequel perspective, it's one of the best sequels I think it's ever been made, and probably the best one we've made.
The main goal of Legacy of the Void is this is our final chapter of StarCraft II. The secondary goal was to make sure that the Protoss had their own unique, awesome campaign.
The fact that Legacy is ending with the Protoss is so fitting, because you look at this ancient race and what they embody, and so much of it started there with them, and now everything is coming back full circle.
It's a franchise that I'm very proud to have been part of.
During the development process and all the hours that we spent playing together in the office, it became and still is my favorite game of all time.
I think StarCraft to me is what started it all. It is the heart of esports for me, and it will always be very near and dear to my heart.
I loved it. I really came to Blizzard just to work on StarCraft 2, so it's been like a dream.
Absolutely. Kind of a piece of me is in that game.
It is like a giant family of people working together, people that are writing code, people that are doing art, and then people that are playing, loving, giving the feedback that we take in and then create the next evolution of the game. For me to have these great people working on this as comrades in arms is awesome, and it extends out to the community playing the game as well.
an exciting day. What an exciting evening. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here for, once again, the reveal of everything you've been waiting for about StarCraft II Legacy of the Void. But I couldn't tell you more about it, but I have some friends who can. So please join me in welcoming the executive producer on StarCraft II Legacy of the Void. It is Blizzard's very own Chris Sigaty.
Siema, Kraków. Thank you so much. Thank you guys so much. Thank all of you guys so much for joining us here today. This is an amazing, amazing event. Maybe it's been absolutely phenomenal. And to have all of you guys joining us here in person, in Poland, in Kraków, has been amazing. On top of that, I just want to start by thanking those of you joining us online. And then also those of you that are at BarCrafts around the world. And specifically, I want to give a shout out. We have a special BarCraft happening in Los Angeles. Thank you guys for joining us.
It's incredible to think that all around the world, we're all sitting or standing somewhere waiting for this moment. But Chris, it's awesome to have you here too, just to talk to you about what this all means. Because, I mean, we're all excited, but for you, it's a little different. You've been there pretty much since the beginning, if I'm not mistaken, for StarCraft.
Yeah, actually, I've been at Blizzard for almost 20 years now. It'll be 20 wow. years in April of next year. Who's counting? But I did. I started as testing, and my first lead testing job was on the original StarCraft. And so here I am. Here I am nearly 20 years later, 17 years. Later, as the executive producer, working with an amazing team that has put together, I think, our best effort yet in StarCraft II.
That's exciting to hear. And yeah, it's a long time coming for you. And since you were there from the beginning, I want to ask, so then now, when Blizzard as a whole hears the word StarCraft or, you know, sees StarCraft on the screen, what does it mean to Blizzard?
It means a lot. It means a little bit of everything, to be honest. And it really starts with commit to quality, which we have some core values at Blizzard that we really take to heart. And the second of those core values is to commit to quality. And that started really becoming a thing with StarCraft, the original StarCraft. And so we showed it at E3 back in either late 96, early 97. And at that time when we were out there, we brought a very quick turnaround build that we had made from the Warcraft 2 engine. Okay. And we got some criticism with that. And when we came back and We had a choice to make. What are we going to do? Are we going to react to that negatively? Are we going to react to that and be defeated? And instead, it became this moment, this iconic moment for us that we look to say, we won't accept that. We're going to go back. Engineers basically restarted on everything, build an all-new engine that became StarCraft. Wow. So it defines very much for us our commit to quality attitude. The other thing it did is it started esports for us.
Of course.
And surprisingly, we were not at yes, and it started this, which is just awesome. We were not expecting it, and it was crazy to have the reaction it had and what happened it really out of Korea and grew into this phenomenon that's here today. That is StarCraft. And finally, I'll just add that it made us think globally. I don't know if you know this, Chobra, but the original StarCraft wasn't even localized into Korean. It's in right. English only. And so suddenly this eye-opening moment for us at Blizzard to say, holy crap, what do we do? We got to think about this a lot more. And it very much defined who we transitioned into and became.
Yeah, I'm laughing because you say that. But then most of us, if you've been watching any StarCraft esports, a lot of us know this famous video coming out from Korea. And somebody out there is like, Plagu! And you're like, why is he saying Plagu? Is that Korean? But then now it all makes sense. It was actually in English out there. They were just trying to figure it out. But so it sounds like the whole esports thing, the whole going completely global for StarCraft was a little unexpected. I imagine there were some other funny or interesting stories for you guys at Blizzard.
Yeah, there's a couple of stories. The one that stands out in my mind, we went to a place, I didn't go, but the vice president one of the vice presidents at Blizzard went to Jeju Island in Korea when it was becoming a phenomenon. And he arrived at this event to meet the vice president of South Korea, which was like, holy crud, they're meeting with a video game developer executive, and this is the vice president of the country of South Korea. And so here we are on this island, and he comes back with pictures, and I'm there as this tester, and I look at these pictures. These pictures have people dressed up as Hydralisks and Zerglings and as Protoss zealots, and they're fully costumed out, and I was just looking at the pictures going, holy smokes, what is going on right now? It may have been the first cosplay. I'm not sure.
Maybe.
That could have been the origination. I don't know. We're not going to claim that. But the other thing, too, was I have this moment. As lead tester of the game, I remember as the game started ramping up competitively, we would see videos in the beginnings of people playing at the pro level, and they were doing hotkeys at this astounding rate. And I remember thinking, holy crap, we didn't test for this. We're screwed. This thing may break. It may actually break. But our excellent engineers, had done a better job than I could have possibly have done testing with our group. But anyway, those are some moments of how it felt at the time.
That's pretty interesting to hear, because a lot of us, we just kind of got the product, right? We enjoyed it, but what a journey it must have been for you guys. Now, you're telling us these stories, and again, I'm just looking out at this crowd, and I can imagine just a crowd around the world, wherever there may be, waiting for this occasion, and that just speaks to the passion that StarCraft 2 community has, and that's a word we talk about a lot in StarCraft, but it's because it's there. It's here.
It's completely real, and it's real on so many fronts. This is clearly a demonstration of how amazingly dedicated and awesome the StarCraft II community is, and this is at the esports level. Yes, give a shout out, because it's amazing. This is the most epic event that I've been at to date, and that's you guys.
Wow.
Thank you guys, for real. The other thing is the modding community. So many games arrived from StarCraft out of modders creating it. The gaming industry today, I feel like, had changed as a result of the passion of the community that was building things, going all the way back to the original StarCraft with tower defense games, and et cetera. And it goes on. And then, of course, there's the stories that we've spent a lot of time trying to craft and make epic. And there's a whole bunch of people that have been tied into this adventure with us. So super exciting on that front. And we know how awesome this community is. We can actually measure it. I'll share this with you guys. We can see when our games, the population of our games, how many people are playing on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis. Okay. And we can look at all the games, and when we launch a new game or launch content for a new game, our other existing games will drop down temporarily for a period of time while they all go over and explore it. Not the StarCraft II audience. They're rock steady, Rock of Gibraltar, StarCraft II. And you mathematically can show it. I mean, it's nuts. So it's super awesome to be a part of a community that's so passionate like this.
Yeah, that is actually really awesome. Yeah, I mean, just look at this. We've been hearing this all weekend. You guys have been chanting, whether it's StarCraft, whether it's whatever it may be related to why we're gathered. Now, of course, we had one fan who's definitely a Protoss fan, if you ask me, out here in front. But there's some of you out there, right, who like Protoss?
Yeah.
And you guys have all been waiting for this moment, I think, today, because I think Legacy of the Void might be about Protoss, if I'm not mistaken.
It is, and that's a moment that we've been waiting for. It's an important moment.
Yeah, so I want to ask, because, of course, we all know that the whole cinematic reveal is going to happen today. But before we get to that, I come from esports. I love announcements of announcements.
Yes.
So is there anything like more that you can share a little bit?
Yes, indeed there is. So we, last year, leading up to Warlords of Draenor, we released the Lords of War animated shorts. And I was a huge fan of it. I think our team was a huge fan of that. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Not me, but yeah, I thought they were great too. And so we've put together an animated short that we'll be releasing later this month that is a focus on where is the story, what's going on with the Protoss right now. It's a piece that we're calling Reclamation. And I brought a sneak peek with us here today. And why don't we kick it off by showing a little bit of that?
Chris, you're like Santa Claus right now, bringing us extra presents. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, let's check out this sneak peek real quick.
Life for iron.
You know what I love about that is, to be very honest, all I saw was like Protoss everywhere, Protoss, Protoss, but that we're all still excited about it because I have to believe that anything you guys provide to us as fans is always amazing. And I have that faith there about Reclamation. Aren't you guys excited about that?
Wow. That's a really high standard to live up to, but we're trying our best. We're trying our best.
You guys have been doing a fantastic job. But ladies and gentlemen, we got that little sneak peek from Chris. Of course, he's our Santa Claus right now. But now to talk a little bit more in detail, we've brought another friend, haven't we, to share more about Legacy of the Void. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the lead designer on Legacy of the Void. It is Jason Huck. Woo.
What a crowd. Thank you so much.
It's exciting,
thank you.
Isn't it?
God, this, yeah, wow. This, thank you so much. The city is beautiful. I've loved it here. Yes, oh yes. Yes.
Yeah, now Jason, before we get into the juicy bits that you've brought for Legacy of the Void, tell us a little bit, so for some people who may have not had a chance to meet you like I have yesterday, all day yesterday, what's your role in StarCraft II Legacy of the Void?
So, I started off on Wings of Liberty as a level designer, and from there, I went on to Heart of the Swarm as the lead campaign designer, and there that was a really awesome experience, because I got to, you know, got to work on the story and making the missions fit with the story, and it's like a you know, strong moment for me there. And now as a lead designer, my task is to more of working with the team to ensure that all the design features come together really well and give us a great and awesome next chapter in the StarCraft II experience.
Oh, that's pretty awesome to hear, man. I mean, now you said you worked on the campaign, you know, as a campaign designer for Heart of the Swarm, and now you're, you know, working at a bit of a, I guess, more overview level for Legacy of the Void, but then tell us, I mean, you have to know the story then for Legacy of the Void, and I know we don't want to spoil anything about the actual ending of the story, but what can we expect from Legacy of the Void?
Yeah, so Legacy of the Void, it tells a story of Artanis, that guy behind me, and it's the story of him and the unification of the Protoss, so the Dark Templar and the Light Templar, and their goal is just to reclaim their homeworld. As you saw, Reclamation, that's like the moments leading right up to the beginning of Legacy of the Void. They also have to deal with this universal threat of Amon, the fallen Zelnaga. So that's big challenges ahead for them.
Okay, so sounds like it's going to be pretty dramatic from the get-go when we go into the story and the campaign. But of course, again, for like Protoss fans, it's like finally our moment. We get to see our race and their story behind all of this. But aside from that, I mean, StarCraft is much more about simply just reading a story. It's a full experience. What else are you excited about for this game?
Well, I feel like this is our best campaign yet. I mean, we have some excellent new missions, new mission mechanics. We've got so many more cutscenes and cinematics. I mean, we have 30-plus cinematics to tell this story. We've got all these great, great new modes. We've got the Archon mode and the co-op missions, automated tournaments. A lot of this stuff's already in beta. And another awesome thing is that all three titles now are standalone, so this is the best time to get into StarCraft II.
Yeah.
Cheer for StarCraft, yeah. That's right.
And you said it earlier, William, about this is the Protoss expansion, and you know, we've been waiting for it. We've been wanting it. It's felt empty, and it's now arriving, so we're super excited about that. I am very proud of the team. I think this is the best version of StarCraft II yet. They've spent a lot of time, in addition to the things that Jason talked about, new cooperative modes, there's also a new user experience, basically, that gets you into the game. And I think it combines all together very well. There's all new revamped UI that's coming online. We've really tried to give a little something for everybody in there. And the team has, I think, killed it. Obviously, you'll have to just trust me on that. But when you play it, let us know. We think it's our best effort yet. The team has done a fantastic job.
You know, you guys haven't... I mean, we could clap all night for these gentlemen up here. And, of course, everyone at Blizzard working on this title. But... you guys have already mentioned a couple things, like Archon mode, and there's been a buzz around the community in the beta of Legacy of the Void. Whether it's balance changes in the multiplayer, whether it's the actual features like Archon mode that people just thought was some myth and dream, these are big changes coming to this game, and in some way I have to imagine as designers, sometimes it's a little bit scary to try that.
It is, but I mean, we got to make the best game here that we want to make, and it requires to be a little risky, a little experimental. and we've had some great success in the beta. We've had excellent feedback from the community on this, and we love it. We love working with the community on this, and we want to keep doing that going forward.
Yeah, I was just going to add on to that. I've been really excited at how courageous the team has been, the StarCraft II team has been. They've made some really dramatic changes to the game. Definitely the most dramatic that we've made so far, and it goes back all the way really to the original StarCraft. We didn't make changes this dramatic between original StarCraft and Brood War. We didn't make it between Liberty and Swarm. Right. And these are big changes, and we think that we have an even more exciting experience coming here on the multiplayer side, and I don't know how you can make it more exciting than this weekend has been already, but they really are putting things in there to continue to up the excitement level of the game. So very proud of the team and how much they've been putting themselves out there and really working with the community to land on something that it's gonna land in its initial form, and I think it's already gonna be exciting, and then we have so much more in front of us to go and change it and continue to escalate it, elevate it up, and improve on it across time. So very excited about where we're about to head.
Well, we've been talking a lot about the game, and you guys have been very just excited about everything we've been talking about, but we're all here to watch something, right? We're all here to watch the cinematic. Guess what? It's not time to watch the Legacy cinematic just yet. I know I got you there.
Ouch.
I know I got you there. But before we do that, because I think this, and this is going to be great. You guys are going to love this, because when we think cinematics, that's why everyone's excited. Blizzard cinematics. I mean, you could sit back and just play them back and forth. So let's take some time to relive some iconic moments from the past games. How does that sound? Let's relive Wings of Liberty. Let's relive some moments from Heart of the Swarm. Ladies and gentlemen, the cinematics from Wings of Liberty and Heart of the Swarm.
They say a man never really knows himself. Until his freedom's been taken away. I wonder, how well do you know yourself? War is coming. With with all its glory and all its horror. Mr. Findlay, your freedom awaits.
Hail, it's about time.
Just a little bit longer, guys. Just a little bit longer.
But I love that the crowd here, when, and we had our one of our casters from WCS mentioning earlier the Viking that lands in the heart of the Sworn Trail. You guys all cheer for him. Me too. Even I know what's coming, but the fact that it's so amazing, every time I see him, I'm like, yeah, go Viking. Oh, no. It just makes me cry a little bit inside as a Terran player. But
Me too, secretly. Don't tell anybody, though.
Oh. Don't tell anybody.
You guys, shh.
But as you guys let out that big sigh, but now, really, I'm not even joking this time, we're on the edge of showing this video. It's time to let it out to the rest of the world. What's going through your minds?
Yeah, it's a hard thing to describe. You know, working on the game, this story goes back 17 years, and this is a conclusion of sorts for these players, for these characters, rather. You know, Rainer, like Kerrigan, Artanis, Zeratul, this is that conclusion to that 17-year build story. So a lot of nostalgia for me, a little bit of onion cutting. It marks just the beginning of what we're going to do with Legacy of the Void, but it does get emotional. I watch our own cutscenes, our own trailers get to these moments, and it hits the heartstrings a bit.
Aww.
Maybe not for you guys, but for me, having worked on it at this point, it does.
Aww.
Sorry, I'm a little
Totally understandable, though. I can't imagine. Jason, what about you? Just ready now to let this out to the rest of the world. Unleash the beast, basically.
I'm not going to hold this up at all. I am so excited. Let's just get this thing going.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Everyone here in Kraków, everyone in Poland, everyone around the world, and of course, all of you guys out there in Los Angeles, it is finally time. We're all here together to watch the Legacy of the Void cinematic.
Swarm brought ruin to our world. Our proud people became refugees. And yet, they could not shatter our unity. For we are bound by the color, the sacred union of our every thought and emotion.
Script ready to like dive this thing up, but that was the first time I was watching it too, and my golly.
Yeah, I know. Golly is not really the word I was hoping for, but I swear this is no joke. William really did not watch it. He had the opportunity to do so, and he waited for this moment to have this moment.
And I'm so glad I got to share that moment with you. And Lisa, you saw that November 10th, 2015. That's so soon. That is when we all get to just put our hands on Legacy of Void and run through that story and experience the whole thing. I mean, Chris and Jason, of course, everybody at Blizzard, thank you so much for making something so amazing and bringing us together to experience this together. Yeah, give them a huge round of applause. It's amazing.
I have to say, I appreciate the thanks, but we are truly honored to be able to share a game like this with you guys, because this is actually what it's all about, is exactly moments like this. And sharing the reveal here, it's already been super special. Sharing this esports moment has been amazing. I'll share one thing with you, William. I am waiting November 10th. I can say the date. November 10th. It's right after BlizzCon, and I'm very excited about it personally. I have twin 7-year-old boys at home, and their first game in their epic, long, storied gaming career was StarCraft II. And they loved it, and they've moved, and they played other games.
Nice.
But I'm serious. I'm waiting for November 10th as well, because I can't wait to share that moment with them and play. You know, it is about esports. It's also about having fun, and I can't wait to have fun with my kids. So I'm really looking forward to it.
That's so true. I'm so glad you brought that up, because I think everyone is just excited with the whole thing. And Jason, now that the secret's out, well, how do you feel?
It's such a relief, and I'm so excited to be able to talk about it more now. And we got so much more to come. We've got the Reclamation release here, like Chris said, later this month. And of course, we've got BlizzCon. We got such a treat there. So can't wait.
It's going to be an exciting few weeks leading up to Legacy of the Void, gentlemen. Well, once again, thank you to everyone here and everyone around the world. And once again, all you guys gathered in Los Angeles for joining us for this reveal. It was absolutely exciting, wasn't it?
Thank you all so very, very much from the bottom of our hearts for letting us share this moment here.
It was such a great event, but that, you know what that means. Now, what a way to go into what could be the most exciting match in the WCS Premier League of 2015. Who's in the final, ladies and gentlemen, Poland? Is it Mana?
It's Mana. It's Mana.
Hasn't it been crazy? What a weekend it has been, Chris. It's been a dream come true. And their PvP and Legacy of the Void is coming out later this year.
I swear, we did not script this. It is unbelievable. We've literally been talking about it. They said it from the casting desk. It seems like we could not have sat around and written this. It would have been cut multiple times of like, that's too unbelievable. I was, while we were watching the movie and watching how it was playing out and then, of course, remembering who's in the finals right now, so crazy that it lined up Protoss versus Protoss with the Legacy of the Void reveal. It's nuts.
Yeah, it's been insane, Jason.
All I got to say is Little Bo Baguette.
Oh, Little Bo gets, but Little Bo versus Mana coming up. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you so much for joining us. And now it's time for the finals of the WCS Premier League Season 3 coming right up.
Yeah! Thank you guys so much. Thank you so
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time. The Season 3 Finals is just around the corner. Welcome to the World Championship Series. Welcome. This is the Premier League. It's been a very, very long season, but only two players remain. It is Poland's own Mana who goes up against a Frenchman in Lilbo. For the first time in StarCraft II WCS history, we have an all-European final, and it's just around the corner. Join me on the desk to break this one down before we get into it. Is In Control, Todd and Nathanius. Welcome to the desk, and what a long season we had, Nathanius.
Yeah, it's been amazing. The games couldn't have asked for anything better. I'm on the edge of my seat looking at them, trying to cast, trying to keep myself together. It's been a phenomenal weekend.
And rightfully so, the two players, the story that we've had coming into this finals, Todd, the two players that are here for this, absolutely fantastic.
Absolutely. It feels like Lilbo was always meant to reach that finals. As for Mana, I really feel like it's this crowd that's giving him power as they cheer him on.
Well, I mean, yeah, just to follow. I really like Chris City's point. He's like, hey, guys, we didn't write this. It wouldn't be believable. He said about a science fiction game about a bunch of aliens killing stuff. Like, it's actually that unbelievable. It's going to be amazing. And, you know, in the past,